CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 7.
Hello students, I'm your friend Premlata. Today we will study about fractions. This is chapter 2 of class 7 NCERT Mathematics. What are fractions and what are their types? So let's go ahead. Just tell me, have you ever gone to a birthday party? Don't you have fun there? Yes! Do you enjoy cake? Yummy! Now tell me, do you eat full birthday cake or you get a part of it? I'm sure you get a part of the cake. So when you have a part of a whole, this is what we call as a fraction. A fraction means a part of a group or a part of a region or a part of a whole thing. Now suppose the cake was cut in 8 equal pieces and you were given only one piece. As it is to be distributed among 8 people now. So can you tell what fraction of cake you got? I'm sure you will say that you got one part out of the 8 parts. So a fraction would be 1 out of 8 or 1 upon 8, or we can say that you ate 1/8 of the whole cake. Now let's learn how to write a fraction. It is written as A upon B, where A is the numerator and B is the denominator. An easy trick to remember which part goes where is that denominator and down both start with the letter D. So the denominator is always the number that is down in a fraction. So, in a fraction 1/8, 1 is the numerator and 8 is the denominator. Let's take another example. What is numerator in 5/7? Think. Yes, 5. And what is the denominator in 5/7? Correct, it's 7. Now let's know about a special type of fraction which we call as a unit fraction. It is the fraction in which the numerator is always 1. I repeat, the numerator should always be 1. The denominator can be any other natural number. Remember that denominator can never be 0. Why can't it be 0? Because 0 cannot be distributed or divided in parts. It is as simple as that. Like, for example, the number of colored parts in a given circle is 1. And the total parts that are equal in number are 3. So, the fraction is 1 by 3. Or, we can say that it is 1/3. Let's take another example. Imagine, there is a pizza in front of you. Yummy! It's delicious. You have been given one slice to eat. Now, the pizza has been sliced in 6 equal parts. So, what fraction have you been given to eat? Yes, the answer is 1 by 6. Or you can say 1 upon 6. Or simply 1/6. So, a special type of fraction in which the numerator is 1 and the denominator is a natural number is called a unit fraction. Now let's know about another type of fraction, which is called proper fraction. Think of a situation that you were hungry and you ate 2 parts out of the 6 parts given in that pizza. So, the fraction of pizza that you ate was 2/6. Now, you were very hungry and you ate 5 parts out of 6. So, the fraction you ate would be 5/6. So, these kind of fractions in which the numerator is less than the denominator, they are called proper fractions. Some more examples of proper fraction would be 3 by 5, 7 by 9. You can give endless number of examples from your daily life. Just remember that numerator should be less than the denominator. Now let's think of a situation, a different kind of situation, where we say that we ate 13 parts of the cake out of 8 parts. Is this really possible? It is not sounding proper. Or we can say that it is improper. How can somebody eat 13 parts out of 8? So, for this kind of situation, we call it as an improper fraction. We also see that improper fraction, numerator is greater than the denominator. Like here, we see another improper fraction. 7 by 4. Just think, how can we eat 7 parts from a cake having just 4 parts? This is only possible if we have 2 big cakes. Each cake is divided into 4 parts. So, we can say we ate all parts, 4 out of 4 from the first cake and 3 parts out of 4 from the second cake. That is 4 by 4 plus 3 by 4 gives 7 by 4. Or we can say that we ate 1 full cake and 3/4 of the other cake. So, in total, we ate 1 whole cake and 3/4 of the other cake. When we write improper fraction in this form, that is 1 and 3/4, this is called a mixed fraction. Some example in daily life which you use are 1.5, 2.5, etc. You must have heard somebody says that he eats 2.5 chapatis. Now, let's know about like fractions. Like fractions are the fractions that have the exact same denominator. I repeat, like fractions are the fractions that have the exact same denominator. That's it. We would be working with whole things that are split into same number of pieces. It doesn't matter what the numerator is, so long as the denominators are the same. Like 1 by 6, 2 by 6, 5 by 6, and 7 by 6. They are all the examples of like fraction, which have the same denominator. And what is the denominator in these fractions? Yes, it is 6. Let's take another example. 3 by 10, 5 by 10, 7 by 10, 9 by 10. These are like fractions, which have the same denominator. And what is the denominator in this case? Yes, it is 10. Similarly, we have other kinds of fraction, which are called unlike fractions. For fractions to be unlike, they have to have different numbers in the denominator. In other words, they have to have different numbers on the bottom of the fraction bar. For example, 3 by 5 and 6 by 7 are unlike fractions. What is the denominator in 3 by 5? It is 5. What is the denominator in 6 by 7? It is 7. As the denominator is different in both cases, so these fractions are unlike fractions. Let's take one more example. Tell whether 5 by 8 and 11 by 9 are unlike fractions or not. Let's check now. What is the denominator in 5 by 8? It is 8. What is the denominator in 11 by 9? It is 9. The denominator is different in both cases. So, 5 by 8 and 11 by 9 are unlike fractions. Now, let's do an activity which will help you understand the concept of equivalent fraction. Get a piece of paper. It can be an A4 sheet or an origami paper or a simple newspaper, whatever is available to you at home. Get one pencil also. Fold the sheet into two equal halves. Now open the sheet. You will observe that the sheet has been divided into two equal halves. Now, with a pencil or pen, shade or color any one part of the sheet. Make sure you shade that part completely. Now tell, what fraction of the paper is colored? I give you some time to think. You must have thought 1 upon 2, or you must have said half, as one part is colored out of the 2. Now fold the sheet again such that it is divided into 4 equal parts. When you open the sheet, you will observe that 2 sections out of the 4 are shaded. Now tell, what fraction of the paper is colored now? I will give you some time to think again. Yes, your answer would be 2/4. Now, you must have realized that in the first stage of the activity, the fraction of the shaded part was 1/2. And in the second stage of the activity, the fraction of the shaded part was 2/4. We know that the area that was shaded was exactly the same in both stages. So we observe that 1/2 is same as 2/4. These type of fractions are called equivalent fractions. Equivalent fractions have the same value, even though they may look different. Like 1/2 is same as 2/4 and is also same as 4/8. Now let's find equivalent fractions of 2/3. For this, we multiply both numerator and denominator by 2. What is 2 times 2? Yes, it is 4. What is 3 times 2? It is 6. So we get the equivalent fraction of 2/3 as 4/6. Similarly, if we want to find out more equivalent fractions of 2/3, we can multiply both numerator and denominator by 3 this time. What is 2 times 3? 6. What is 3 times 3? It is 9. So, we get the equivalent fraction of 2/3 as 6/9. We can say that equivalent fractions can be obtained if we multiply or divide the numerator and denominator of the fraction by the same number. Now let's solve some questions related to fractions. Question 1. What fraction of a day is 6 hours? I repeat, what fraction of a day is 6 hours? I'll give you few seconds to think and then we will discuss the answer. I hope you found the answer. The answer is 6/24. And if we simplify this fraction, we will get the answer 1/4. How did I get that? For this, we can divide both the numerator and the denominator by 6. What is 6 divided by 6? It is 1. What is 24 divided by 6? It is 4. So, 6/24 can be written as 1/4. Let's move on to the other question. Question 2. Which of the following is the bigger fraction? 5/9 or 7/9? I repeat, which of the following is the bigger fraction? 5/9 or 7/9? Just think, again giving you few seconds to think. Yes, it is very easy. As 7 is greater than 5, so we can say that 7/9 is greater than 5/9. Let's go to the third question now. Question 3. What is 3 by 4 plus 2 by 4? I repeat, what is 3 by 4 plus 2 by 4? Just give it a try. I will give you some time to think. As both are like fractions, the denominator is same in both. So, we just need to add the numerator to find the solution. As 3 plus 2 is 5, so the answer we get after adding the fraction is 5 by 4. We can also say that 3 by 4 plus 2 by 4 is equals to 5 by 4. Now let's move on to other question. Question 4. What is 1/4 of 100? I repeat, what is 1/4 of 100? Think for a moment. I am waiting. If your answer is 25, then you are correct. Now let's see how we got the answer. As 1 by 4 is half of 1 by 2 and 1 by 2 is half of a whole thing, we will follow the same pattern for 100. What is half of 100? 50. And what is half of 50? It is 25. So we got the answer as 25. We can say that 1/4 of 100 is 25. With this, I would like to end the session for today. But before that, let's revise what all we have learned today. Today, we learned that fractions is a part of a whole thing. It is written in the form of A upon B, where A is the numerator and B is the denominator. We learnt that the fraction in which the numerator is 1 is called unit fraction. Fractions in which the numerator is less than the denominator are called proper fractions. And the fraction in which the numerator is more than the denominator are called improper fractions. The fractions with the same denominators are called like fractions. And the fractions with the different denominators are called unlike fractions. We also learnt about equivalent fractions. Equivalent fractions have the same value even though they may look different. They can be obtained if we multiply or divide the numerator and the denominator of a fraction by the same number. Let's give you some activity to do at home. Try dividing your chapati in two equal parts and distribute it among your brother or sister. You both will get half part, or we can say that 1 by 2. Now take another chapati and divide it in 4 equal parts. Distribute it among 4 members of your family. Each one will get 1/4 part. Just for fun, keep the half piece of the chapati and 1/4 piece of the chapati together. What is the sum of both the fractions? As we know, 1 by 2 is equals to 2 by 4. It is equivalent fraction. If we multiply 2 with the numerator and denominator of 1 by 2, we get 2 by 4. And when we add 2 by 4 plus 1 by 4, we get 3 by 4. Let's do the same activity with pizza this time. This pizza has 6 pieces in total. And remember, they are going to be equal. Take one piece for you. The fraction of pizza you got is 1/6. Now give 2 pieces of the pizza to your mother. By pieces, I mean slices. So give 2 slices to your mother. The fraction of pizza she gets is 2/6. Now give 2 pieces of slices to your father. The fraction he got is 2/6. How much fraction is left now? We see that 1/6 plus 2/6 plus 2/6 is 5/6. So how many pieces are left? Only 1. The left fraction of the pizza is 1/6. I hope you enjoyed the session, refreshed your concepts, and learned some new things. Thank you for being a good listener. Hope to talk to you again. Bye and have a nice day.
So friends, you were just listening to the series Dhwani Shala.
Production assistants, Meenakshi Kukreti, Tanu Gupta and Jagbandhu Jana.
Recorded by Shanu Muksim and Vikas Sangwan.
This program was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.